Hello everyone, welcome back to our second session all together. How was your break, everyone? Did you enjoy during your break? Was your break fun? Was your break great? Yeah, so it might be yes, it was. Some of you might, yes, it was, or yes, it great, like this, right? And some of you might say, oh, the child is a little bit bored because I just stay at home even though I have break. So anyway, I hope that you can make your own feel fun even though you stay at home, and also you can enjoy about the video lesson of your study too, because during this time no one want to go out, right? And you know, one can go to school. So now let's move to our today lesson. You need 8 hour world. So in the listening express one, we still study the same unit, but today we focus on workbook warm up listening, because warm up listening you already learned on Fridays already about what? About warm up listening too, but you just only choose T for true or F for false and fill in the blank to answer the question. But today you are going to learn about warm up listening again, but about the grammar, about their workbook. So we focus on listen to fill in the blank, right? So you have to listen from the audio track on audio track 73 and fill in the blank. So please open the book on page 18 in our workbook all together, so that you can learn our today lesson. All right, everyone, I hope that you can understand how to do this one, because in the listening normally we have fill in blank, listen to fill in the blank, listen to fill in the blanks a lot, and most of the exercise in the workbook just only listen to fill in the blank, but the difference is only the story, right? All right, so now teacher would like you to listen this one 5 times. I give you 5 times to listen in this one, and I hope that you can complete this one well based on your own ability and based on what you already listened from or your track. So some of you might say that, teacher, I saw only you add only 1 time in the video. How can I listen 5 times? You can move back, okay? Move back and move back again and again 5 times, so that you can listen about this one. All right, are you ready? Now let's start.
Warm up listening.
Grandpa Joe, do you like to travel?
I do. I want to travel all over the world someday.
We have that in common, Mindy. I love to travel. I've been to many places around the world.
Where have you been, Grandpa?
I've been to places in Asia and Europe.
What was your favorite place to visit?
France was the best place to explore. There's so much to see there. I even went to the top of the Eiffel Tower.
Wow! I'll save my money and go there someday too. I'd also like to visit China.
I've been to China. The Great Wall is amazing.
Great job, everyone. Have you done? I hope that you can complete all the correct answer, and you also can use the chat with the correct answer. So now let's check the answer with the teacher all together, even though you cannot complete all the correct answer or some part you missed, but now you can check with the teacher. All right, so this is the conversation between a granddaughter and a grandpa, right? A grandpa and a granddaughter, you can say like this. So warm up listening, Grandpa Joe. So the grandpa's name is Joe, right? So Grandpa Joe, do you like to travel? So the girl asked, do you like to travel? So some of you might ask the teacher, why here is a question form and why do we use small letter in the question form here? Because it should be the capital letter when the word that start at the beginning of the question, right? Or at the center of the question. Yeah, you can say like this. But actually, in this sentence, the word that come at the beginning of the sentence is grandpa. So the grandpa here is the subject that come at the beginning of the sentence, not do. So you might ask the teacher, so why grandpa here come up at the beginning of the sentence? Because it is about a question form. But you can see the comma here. So this is only the phrase that they just call about the grandpa name. After that, ask the question. Like I can say, oh, Terry, where have you been? Or like I can say, Miley, do you like pizza? Like this. So first you call the name, after that you ask the question like this. All right. Now let's move to the next one. All right. I want to travel all over the world someday. I want to travel all over the world someday. So this is about the girl feeling that she want to tell to her grandpa. And then grandpa said, we have that in common. Okay, we have that in common. We have that in common. So in common here is mean normally, right? Normally. Meaning I love to travel. I've been to many places around the world. I've been to many places around the world. So you cannot see the letter clearly, you can also listen from my voice. Alright, so I've been to many places around the world. So this is what a grandpa answered to Mindy, right? And she asked, what was your favorite place to visit? Then Mindy asked, right? She asked, where have you been, grandpa? Where have you been, grandpa? So where have you been, grandpa? So it seems like she wants to know a lot about the grandpa, about his traveling, right? And then he said, I've been to many places in Asia and Europe. In Asia and what? And Europe. So do you know what Asia country are there? So Asia country, we have China, we have Cambodia, we have Thai, we have Laos, we have Myanmar, we have South Korea, and so on. And Europe country, we have what? We have England, we have Italy, we have France, we have Germany, we have Switzerland, New Zealand, USA, and so on. These are we call Europe country, right? And Asian country, like our country, also called Asian country. And Thai, our neighbor, also Asian country, right? All right, now let's go to the next one. And then she asks, what was your favorite place to visit? What was your favorite place to visit? So she asked, well, what was the most place that he liked to visit, right? And then he said, France was the best place to explore, and then to stop, right? To explore. So how many places does he like to visit? Okay, there's here with the short form of there is, right? So the short form of there is there's. There's so much. There are so much to see there. There's so much to see there. So his favorite place about the place that he have been to visit is what? Is France country, right? But what would he like in that country? So we can go on. I even went to the top of the Eiffel Tower. So he would like to visit the French country, and his favorite place there is the Eiffel Tower, the high building or the high tower in France. All right? Next, you say, wow. I'll here the short form, I'll be right. I'll save money and, sorry, here we have my two. I'll save my money and go there someday too. I also like to visit China. So grandpa, his favorite place, only one place, but Mindy, when she heard about grandpa, she also want to visit there, but the one place that she like is China, right? Country, and grandpa say, I've been to China. So, oh, he also have been to China too, right? I've been to China. It seems like he has a lot of place to visit, or he have been to many places. The Great Wall is amazing. It's amazing. All right, and thank you so much, everyone. So now the teacher provide the answers already. And in this one, they would like to talk about travel around the world. It seems like the grandpa, he would like to travel a lot, right? So he would like to travel in Asia and also in Europe. These are about the place that he have been there. And there are many countries that he have been to. And the country that he would like to visit is France, because he would like to visit the Eiffel Tower so much. And he also known about the Great Wall in China too, because this is about amazing place in China, the famous place in China. Like in Cambodia, the famous place that the tourists would like to visit in our Cambodia is Siem Reap in Angkor Wat Temple, right? Angkor Wat Temple. And in France, they also have one of amazing place that the tourists would like to visit too, is the Eiffel Tower. And in China, they also have amazing place too, that called the Great Wall, the wall that they built around 500 years, right? Around 500 years. So they spent a lot of years to build about that wall in order to protect his country from the enemies. All right, everyone, so now our today lesson is finished. If there's still any question, you can ask your homeroom teacher for more detail. So goodbye, everyone. See you tomorrow.